Welcome to the American Museum of Natural History and its exhibition, Lizards and Snakes Alive. The museum's respected Department of Herpetology has put together this amazing display of 60 animals from 5 continents. It's been a huge hit with visitors, many who have returned time and time again, not only to check out these exotic animals up close, but to find out about the diversity of life, the fragility of nature, and why we need to study and protect these species.
This exhibition does a remarkably good job at talking about the real diversity of squamates. There are more species of squamates in the world than there are species of mammals. So people think they know something about birds and mammals and maybe even amphibians. Squamates is a group that people, they may keep snakes, they may keep a lizard or two, but it's very unusual. It's a unique exhibit, and this really talks about the evolution of squamates. It talks about their diversity on the planet, and it really speaks directly to the huge diversity of how they make their livings on the planet. It's an amazing exhibition.
The exhibition is divided into 4 sections, the first of which features an endangered rhinoceros iguana, collared lizards, green basilisks, and many other squamates. Squamate is Latin for scaled. It's simply another term used to describe lizards and snakes. This ancient group is more diverse than mammals and as old as dinosaurs. Many of those that we see in the first section rely on keen sight and sticky tongues to hunt their prey. Now this iguana, I understand, is endangered. Does that have something to do with why you chose him to be first?
Well, yes, in part. I mean, the fact that he's large and imposing and gets people's attention as they come in the door. But these are endangered. Unfortunately, they live on an island, has a lot of people and a lot of dogs and a lot of pigs, and these things evolved without any predators to speak of at all, except maybe some big hawks. So they have really largely disappeared from the wild.
Visual panels help guide visitors around the exhibits. Educational, scientific, and geographical information is presented in a concise snapshot that puts the reptile into immediate context for people passing by.
It says what they eat, where they're from, how big they get, what it is, what their close relatives are, maps of where they are. And I really like this part, which is the close relatives. So we actually, these are just the beginnings of the explanation of the diversity of these particular groups.
In the second section, visitors discover a group of squamates who rely on their tongues, not only for capturing prey, but as a special sense organ, allowing them to literally feel their immediate environment. These include the veiled chameleon, tropical girdle lizards, Gila monsters, blue-tongued skinks, and geckos.
The thing about geckos is this is the first of the whole other side of the squamate diversity. These things use their tongue like snakes do for sensing the world around them, which has allowed them to not hunt it in the daytime but actually hunt at night. But geckos have the added specialization of having these feet that allow them to run up on the surface of the glass. There's video interactives where the kids can actually, they can pan and they can move a camera around and they can focus on things in the cage.
But while the specially designed interactives and video galleries have proven to be incredibly popular, there is nothing that draws a bigger crowd than the huge Burmese python, the centerpiece of the third section of Lizards and Snakes Alive. There are many other varieties of serpents that frighten and excite the visitors. The Amazonian tree boa, gabo viper, and red spitting cobra. This section highlights squamates without limbs and how they have adapted to a whole new level of traits such as heat sensing, deadly venom, constriction, and expandable jaws.
It's interesting. We find actually that a lot more people are fascinated by snakes than are afraid of them. And this is a good exhibition to get over the fear, and it's also a good exhibition to learn about snakes if you're fascinated by them.
To take the educational and scientific aspects of the exhibition further for the younger demographic, an entire area is dedicated to hands-on learning activities, including interactive puzzles, touchable fossils, skin textures, recognizing camouflaged squamates in their habitats, and assembling skeletons. Here, children and their families can further explore the evolutionary and behavioral squamate traits, such as physical differences between snakes and lizards.
It really is a family kind of exhibition. Families come back over and over again. There's interactives for the kids. There's things for all ages. This exhibition is really about the science of squamates, so it dispels a lot of myths and brings a lot of information, real information, about squamates in a way that I think the public will really appreciate.
You've witnessed how popular this display has proven to be at the American Museum of Natural History. No doubt the title itself attracts a lot of visitors, and strong word of mouth is also a major factor. But for both children and adults alike, it is ultimately a perfect combination of education, science, and research that makes lizards and snakes alive a must-see experience.